was doing Clock Watchers, and I happened to be there at WHBQ one night in July of 1954. And I was there that night because some of my high school playing football buddies from Jackson wanted me to show them around WHBQ radio, because as I said, everybody in Jackson listened to WHBQ. So I'm showing them around the station where I do my morning show and all the other studios. And all of a sudden, I see the switchboard light up, lit up like a Christmas tree. And I thought, what's that all about? And we had a DJ at night from 9 to midnight. His name was Dewey Phillips. He did a show called Red Hot and Blue, where literally he played black music for white kids. Now remember, this was before rhythm and blues turned into rock and roll. Talking about 1954. And I went in, I said, excuse me, guys. And I excused myself from the fellas, and I went into his control room, and I discovered that Sam Phillips, who founded Sun Records, had walked in and handed Dewey an acetate copy, not a test pressing, hadn't even been tested yet, but he wanted him to test it on the air to see how this record, this song, would be accepted by the listeners. He played it once, he played it twice, he played it three times, four times, five times. The listeners just wanted to hear it over and over again. Played it seven times in a row. And the name of the song was That's All Right Mama. And it was by a truck-driving singer for Crown Electric named Elvis Aaron Presley. And Sam Phillips happened to have the phone number of Gladys and Vernon, his parents, who lived in low-rent housing called Lauderdale Courts out in East Memphis. And I was designated as the one to go to the telephone and call to see where Elvis was, because we wanted to get him to come down to the station. And so I called, Gladys answered, and they were listening, and they heard the excitement. And they said, well, he went to the Suzor's number 2 over on Decatur Street to see a double feature Western. He was so nervous about his record being played on the air that he went to the theater. So they walked up and down the aisle, found him sitting there by himself in this dark theater, whispered to him about the excitement about That's All Right Mama being generated by Dewey Phillips. And they got in their truck and they went down to, or came down to the Hotel Chiska. We were on South Main Street there in downtown Memphis on the mezzanine floor. And this guy named Elvis walked in. Dewey put him down in front of a microphone and just started talking to him. And he said, I want to interview you. And about 15 minutes after this conversation had transpired, he said, well, that's all I need to know. And I remember Elvis said, I thought you were going to interview me. He said, son, I just did. He had no idea the microphone was on. And he said many times later, had he known he was being interviewed, he wouldn't have been able to talk because he would have been so nervous. So I met Elvis that night. He became my friend. And he continued to be my friend until the day he died.